So once again, being with your body, aware of the space, aware of your physical experience in the space. And noticing if there's anything about your physical space that needs to be adjusted in order to have more stability and balance, more relaxation and ease. Doing a brief scan through the body, allowing any areas of tension to release and relax. Bringing a very kind gaze to your physical experience, a nurturing awareness. And coming back to your motivation, thinking about the purpose of our life, to understand and alleviate suffering, to understand and bring about happiness and well-being. In order to do this, examining deeply the causes for each, developing the tools for us to work with each. And all of this mental energy, may it be directed towards the fulfillment of our fullest human potential, so that we can be of greatest benefit to all living beings, including ourselves. And you can reframe that into words that resonate for you, but touch back in to purpose, to motivation. And shifting your focus to the breath. And now shift from breath awareness to observation of thought, as if releasing your focus into something more expansive. Still choosing not to follow distractions, noting them, returning to observation. But imagine that your focus somehow opens up, holding more, still vivid, still bright. And if it feels like your focus gets trapped in a certain train of thought, or if it becomes too floating away, gently bring yourself back to awareness, watching, not chasing, not avoiding. Just watch. and gradually become less interested in what you watch and more interested in the ability to watch. The thoughts continue, but your focus on them de-emphasized. Maybe it's like looking for gaps between the clouds or going up above them. You know about the weather, but you're more interested in the sky itself, bringing your focus more intentionally there. And begin to be curious about who is it that has this spacious mind. Both sky and clouds, minds and mental factors, levels of consciousness. Who is it that seems to contain it all or observe it all in amongst it all? Without chasing a conclusion, just be curious. Cultivating a spacious, open question. And now gently meet that curiosity with the suggestion that any whiff of inherence, permanence, solidity, ownership is an illusion. No inherently existent self. No inherently existent mind. No inherently existent body. Place those suggestions in the space of your curiosity. There is experience, but that's different to identity. There is identity, but no need or reason for identification. Self just merely labeled on the collection. Nominal identity without identification. Empty because dependent. And then think, from emptiness arises the embodiment of compassionate ethics. Golden light, transparent and radiant. Shakyamuni Buddha. And use this idea and this image to connect with your own outer and inner sense of refuge. Those qualities and abilities that protect your mind from suffering and from giving harm. Takes this shape, golden and radiant. At his heart center is Prajnaparamita. Connect with her as the embodiment and representative of outer and our own developing inner wisdom. The wisdom realizing emptiness personified. Archetypal and embodied, there in the space in front, at Shakyamuni Buddha's heart. And at her heart center, surrounding the syllable ah is the Heart Sutra mantra. Tayata om gate gate paragate parasam gate bodhisoha. Indicating the way to Buddhahood, to full enlightenment, is through the five Mahayana paths. The series of realizations our own mind will undergo to free ourselves from suffering and ignorance and afflictions. The transformative process of developing our fullest potential to its utmost extent. Represented by, embodied by these syllables at her heart. From these syllables, infinite light emanates. Imagine oneself and all other sentient beings gaining a realization of emptiness. Picture that future happening now as light goes out, dispelling the darkness of ignorance. Clearing your own ignorance, ripening your own qualities, clearing the ignorance of others, ripening their imprints for wisdom as well. The earth becomes blanketed in light. All six realms become pervaded by light. and add the mantra to the visualization, bringing strength and inner as well as outer resonance.
Taya ta, ga te ga te, para ga te, para sam ga te, bodhisoha. Taya ta, ga te ga te, Aragate, Arasamgate, Bodhisoha. Tayata, Gate, Gate, Aragate, Parasamgate, Bodhisoha. Tayata, Gate, Gate, Aragate, Arasamgate, Bodhisoha. Tayata, Gate, Gate, Aragate, Parasamgate, Bodhisoha. Tayata, Gate, Gate, Aragate, Parasamgate, Bodhisoha. Tayata, Gate, Gate, Aragate, Parasamgate, Bodhisoha.
And the mantra dissolves and absorbs into Prajnaparamita, who dissolves and absorbs into Shakyamuni Buddha, who dissolves and absorbs into you. Blessing your body, speech, and mind. Return to spacious awareness without analysis. and dedicate. May all beings everywhere, plagued by sufferings of body and mind, obtain an ocean of happiness and joy by virtue of my merits. May no living creature suffer, commit evil, or ever fall ill. May no one be afraid or belittled with a mind weighed down by depression. May the blind see forms and the deaf hear sounds, and those whose bodies are worn with toil be restored on finding repose. May the naked find clothing, the hungry find food. May the thirsty find water and delicious drinks. May the poor find wealth, those weak with sorrow find joy. May the forlorn find hope, constant happiness and prosperity. May there be timely rains and bountiful harvests. May all medicines be effective and wholesome prayers bear fruit. May all who are sick and ill quickly be freed from their ailments. Whatever diseases there are in the world, may they never occur again. May the frightened cease to be afraid, and those bound be freed. May the powerless find power, and may people think of benefiting each other. For as long as space remains, for as long as sentient beings remain, until then may I too remain to dispel the misery of the world. Okay. So have a nice night. And if right before bed you can set an intention to see your dreams with lucidness, it will help. Laila Tov.